From Los Angeles to a worldwide audience, this is Boaz Power TV, where we take your life to the next level. Now, internationally known speaker and author, here's Boaz.
Hi, welcome to the Power Show. You are part of the Power Nation, and I'm delighted that you're here, because we take your life to the next level by helping you improve your attitude, your relationships, your finances, and your career. This is episode number 64 of Boaz Power TV, and I call this one Prosperity and the Gulf Stream. Many years ago, when the United States was first becoming a country, there was an amazing gentleman who was part of our early history that invented a number of things, and he gives us a real insight as to how to become more prosperous in our modern times. This particular gentleman discovered the Gulf Stream. He would go back and forth from the United States to France, and he noticed that the ships sailed faster one way than they did the other direction. So, brilliant as he was, he started to put a thermometer in the water, and he discovered that certain waters were warmer along the Atlantic, and that's where ships sailed at a different pace. And he discovered the Gulf Stream. He also discovered the odometer. This man I'm talking about was our first postmaster. And so he would put special devices on the wheels of wagons to see how many clicks there were between one location and another, and he discovered and invented the original odometer. He also is responsible, if I did not have graduated bifocals in my glasses, but the glasses with the actual line in between, he's the one who invented those. Do you know what he did? So amazing. Took the frames of glasses and took half of a frame from a close-up view and the other half from a distance and just slipped them together into the frame. And eventually people learned how to make one piece of glass with the line in the middle. Incredible. And he also invented the lightning rod. By now you may have guessed I'm talking about Benjamin Franklin, amazing gentleman. Not only a great politician and statesman, but also a great inventor. And what does he have to do with your prosperity? A lot. Because his picture appears on something I want you to carry at all times. The $100 bill. The $100 bill. One of the things I teach people at my seminars is in order to become prosperous, we have to feel money, real money. Cash is real money. Credit cards and checks and so forth, those are monopoly. This is real money. So I want you to carry a $100 bill with you at all times. Put it in your wallet, in your purse, look at it every time you go in there. Don't fold it up so you can't see it. Because what this will do every time you look in there for any other money, it'll make you feel prosperous. Only 3 or 4% of the people in this country carry this kind of denomination. Check their finances. They're usually doing great. And then something else I suggest you do, get some 20s and put them around the house. On the end table, by the bed, on the counter, the bathroom, on the counter, the kitchen. If you have teenagers, tape them down real good. And then I get people to start saving $1 a day. $1 a day, get an envelope, put $1 in there every day. The subconscious mind responds to real money happening. It's not just saying, well, you saved $1 today. No, it sees money. You see, whatever the mind focuses on expands, and most people focus on very little money. So if I look in my wallet and all I've got is 1s, 5s, 10s, and 20s, then that's different than when I look and I see a $100 bill. So I want you to carry a $100 bill, 20s around the house. Put dollar bills in an envelope, and then when you have enough in the envelope to open a savings account, go down to the bank and open a savings account. This is not for mad money or vacations. This is your permanent fortune fund. And get a little passbook, the old-fashioned one, and put in the new amount each time in the new total. And after a few months, you'll be amazed how this will accumulate because you'll be focusing on actual money. I know a lady who came to one of my seminars in San Diego a few years ago, had not saved money in years. She comes to my seminar, takes this seriously, gets the $100 bill, 20s around the house, starts saving $1 a day. 5 years later, she has $35,000 in her fortune fund, cannot even tell you where all the money came from, just like most people can't tell you where the money is lost. So the affirmation for this episode of Boaz Power TV is, I am an expert money manager. Please write that down. I am an expert money manager. And say it first thing in the morning, last thing at night. You'll be amazed what it'll do to the way you handle money. And here are some other ideas that I share with you often about getting your power back concerning money. Take your power back. First, lower your expenses. It's much easier to accumulate money when you lower your expenses. You know, when I had problems with money a few years ago, went into an apartment that didn't cost very much money, but I was able to save a lot. Drove a car that was 10 years old, paid for, and was in perfectly fine shape, so I didn't have a car payment. So lower your expenses, pay in cash. If you can't afford to buy something, wait, and then pay off your debts, even one at a time, starting with the smallest one first, and save some money. Save some money. Save some money. The $100 bill will help you see money in a whole different way. If you like these messages, and many people around the world do, they find them very beneficial, please forward this to five people you know. Ask them to go to my website, boazpower.com. Get them to sign up for this free weekly broadcast, and let's help them manage their money better also. You are special. You are unique. You are destined for greatness. I believe in you because you are a champion. Have a powerful day.
This has been Boaz Power TV. To comment, see other episodes, or to subscribe to this free broadcast, go to our blog at boazpower.com. That's boazpower.com. We're here to take your life to the next level.